Have you ever wanted to get the film look inside Premiere Pro? You can only do so much with Lumetri Color. If you really want to add that film grain and different effects that come with that authentic film look, you might have to use a third-party plugin. That's where Dehancer comes in. In this video, I'm going to be reviewing Dehancer's plugin for Premiere Pro to see how you can add the film look to your footage. Feel free to download Dehancer in the link below. You can start your free trial, and if you use my promo code JohnTheVideoGuy, you can get 10% off your order. So without further ado, let's dive into today's video. So I'm inside Premiere Pro, and to sample Dehancer, I have some sample clips on my timeline. I have a drone shot, some log footage of a waterfall, and to really test out the film effects, I have a skateboarder at sunset. So to get started, to apply a Dehancer to your clip, just go to the effects panel and type in Dehancer. After it installs, it's like a normal effect, so you can search for it, apply it to your clips. Once it's applied, you can go up to your effects controls panel, and where you want to go first is actually under film. You will want to disable the film. Automatically, Dehancer applies a film profile to your footage, and before you really dive in, you want to disable it. Same with film grain. You might want to go down under film grain and disable that as well. Now the first place you want to go to is under input. You'll notice that you have some different color spaces that you can choose from. From the dropdown, there's Rec 709, Rec 2020, or at the very bottom, if you shot on a specific camera and you know what camera you shot on, you can select your own camera. But in this case, for the drone footage, I'm going to select Rec 709 since that's the color space I shot in. Now next, you can scroll down and you have the film tab. So now we can enable that. And next to profile, under the dropdown, there's several different film profiles that you can choose from. I recommend just experimenting with all of them, see how all of them look. They all have a different feel to them. For this drone shot, I'm going with the Kodak Gold 200 profile. I think this looks really nice. And like I said, you can start today with a free trial so you can get your hands on all these different profiles and see which ones you like the most. Now let's go over to the waterfall footage. Now this was shot in log. So what I'm gonna do in this case is actually select my camera. So I'm gonna scroll down and find the Sony A7S Mark III. And now you'll notice in the program monitor, it converts it basically from log to a manageable color space. Now we can go under film, enable it. And for this shot, I'm gonna choose Fuji Color C200. This looks pretty good to me. Now underneath film, there's a few different options. There's a tab called Film Developer. What I like using in here is the contrast. So if you need to boost the contrast, you can turn that value up. So if we enable it, maybe turn this to 30 or so, you can see there's a lot more contrast in the shot now. You also have film compression and also the expand option. So if you wanted to add faded film, you can turn the black point down a little bit and you kind of introduce more black or white into your image. Now, if we scroll down under film grain, we can enable it. You have a lot of different options to choose from. You can choose the amount, so you can knock it down or increase the amount if you want. The actual size of the film grain you can change as well. Now, what's really unique with Dehancer's film grain is that you can select certain parts to add grain to. So you can add more grain into the highlights or midtones, or maybe decrease the grain from the shadows of your image. So this is a nice way to control how much grain is in your image. Now, one other cool tab is the color head tab. This is where you can really fine tune the color. So for example, if I wanted to introduce more yellows and orange, I can click and drag these sliders over to really make it more colorful. And probably one of the coolest features inside the plugin is the halation and the bloom effect. And to really showcase this, I'm going to use a clip of a skateboarder at sunset. And for this shot, I'm going to change the film profile to Fujichrome. This gives a nice warm feel to the shot, and these effects are really going to pop. So you'll notice that there's a halation tab. When you twirl down, you can enable it. And what this does is essentially adds a glow around your reds and the highlights of the image. So you have different options here. You can change the amplify amount to add more. You can add some smoothness. And where you want to go to really add a lot more is under the local and global diffusion options. So once you get those settings adjusted, if we zoom in here, you can really see the effect if I toggle it on and off. You can see the glowing red, orange, amber edges really pop in this image. So let's go down to bloom. This will essentially add more highlights to your image and kind of bloom out your image. So you have different options here. You can choose to amplify it. You can choose to add some diffusion to it. And if we take a look and zoom in here, you can see what it does to the highlights, to the skateboard there, and to the sunset. Just kind of increases the highlights a little bit. Now, one other cool setting is the vignette options. You can choose to change the exposure and the size of the vignette. But what's really cool is down below, you can actually offset the vignette. So for example, if I wanted to point this vignette to maybe just enclose the top right side, I can offset the X and Y values and kind of align my vignette in a custom area. Now, if we scroll down, you have some more options down below. You have the film breath, which essentially adds breathing to your film. So you'll notice that it kind of flickers a little bit if you mess with those settings. So overall, there's a lot of different settings you can play with to get different film looks inside Premiere Pro. Dehancer also has a mobile app as well. And just to show you guys how that works, if we open up the mobile app, you can choose to upload your photos or video. It will load in the app and you can easily see based on the thumbnails, the different looks, which is really nice. So you can scroll through the looks, select which one you'd like to start on. I'm gonna choose this Fuji one right here. And once you click on edit, you'll have different options that you can play with. You can scroll through the different settings, very similar to the plugin inside Premiere Pro. At the very bottom, you can scroll through like color head, change the values. If you want to enable or disable an option, you can just click once at the bottom. That'll enable or disable it. And here you can see the before and after videos of Dehancer's mobile app. Overall, I think Dehancer is great if you really want that film look. Just a few notes that I notice on my end using it. It is a very intensive plugin inside Premiere Pro. So, you know, if you plan to use it, I would have a very fast GPU and a computer that you can edit on. So at the end of the day, I think it really comes down to your own needs. I think if you really want that film look, this is a really nice plugin. And is something to worth considering. If you don't work with film a lot or you don't really care about adding film grain and the halation and bloom effect, this plugin might not be for you. You know, you can do a lot of color correction already in Lumetri Color, can use a lot of LUTs and different things like that or effects. But I think when it comes to film emulation, I think this is a really solid plugin. Let me know what you guys think of Dehancer down in the comments below. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.